Dougs, welcome back to Ivy League, powered by Riverland Roofing and the Ole Miss Spirit. I'm here with Ulysses Doo Bentley. How you doing, man?
Great, man. How you doing?
Pretty good, man. It's good to have you on.
Yeah.
So let the people know just where you're from and the early beginnings.
Originally, you know, I was born in New Orleans, Louisiana, and then I was raised in Houston, Texas. Mm. You know, I moved there after Katrina, so Houston is just like home for me.
So how old were you when everything happened with Katrina?
Probably like 5 years old. Yeah. I still remember everything, stuff like that. But, you know, Houston is just home.
Yeah, how long did it take to like, okay, it's Houston, like we're from Houston, like we feel comfortable in this new place and stuff like that, making new friends at school and all that?
It definitely was kind of different because, you know, just being in New Orleans, I was used to being around, like, all my friends from there and then being around all my cousins and stuff like that because, you know, we all pretty much live closer to each other. But when I moved to Houston, like, man, it really didn't feel like anything different at all. So Houston was definitely just – I love it. So I just love to be there so much.
All right, so stayed home-ish. Mm. Playing at SMU, what was that like and how was the process or – and committing to SMU and what was it like coming out of high school?
The process with that, man, it definitely was like it was cool, man. Like the head coach, you know, he would come and see me each and every week, man. Mm-hmm. He would come to my house, come and see my people. It just felt like it was just so family like oriented and like, man, I just knew from there, like, yeah, man, I just committed there and I was like, yeah, I love SMU.
Yeah. That's what's up, man. Having a because you know I went to school not too far from my hometown, and it was cool just to be at home and have like 30 people come to every home game and stuff like that.
Yeah,
I bet you was hounded for tickets.
Oh yeah, definitely. Because you know SMU was definitely in Dallas, but most of my people were like in New Orleans or like Houston, so they definitely like just took the ride along there. It was easy.
Yeah. All right, so. Give me like SMU welcome to what was the conference?
AAC.
AAC. Welcome to the AAC. Welcome to a college football moment that you had.
It probably was Texas State game. Like that was like my first game I ever scored for real. I had like a little outside zone run, and then like I juked the guy, made him look really bad, and then I scored or whatever. But that was kind of like my moment right there.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. So would you rather have an outside zone or an inside zone and weave up in between there and split somebody down the middle?
To me, it really doesn't matter, man. You know, I'm kind of like a finesse back, so I can go outside zone, inside zone. Just, you know, once I hit that hole, I'm gone. So the runs really don't matter to me.
Yeah, no, for sure. What about catching out the backfield? Like, you feel like that's a big part of your game or something that you want to focus on and get kind of a little bit of production out of?
Definitely, yeah. I want to get a little bit more of that because, you know, I like running the ball and stuff, but I like when Kiffin, you know, lines me up at slot receiver, have me doing stuff out of the backfield because it kind of just confuses y'all
and
a lot of other teams too. So I definitely like doing
that. Now, y'all get nifty with it. We'll look out there and see doing a slot and everybody, trick play, this and that. Like, and recently y'all have been running a bunch of reverses.
Yeah.
That have been killing us, absolutely killing us. But, you know, that's just how Lane do things, man.
Yeah,
creative mind.
Yeah, it's a creative mind. Yeah. Man. His offense is great, too.
How about you? You think you can write up a play?
Definitely.
Yeah?
Yeah, definitely. Just, like, learning all the stuff from, you know, Kiffin and stuff, like all the plays that we see he has set up and all the different reverses and trick plays and stuff, I definitely could create a play.
You definitely could create a play?
Yes.
Yeah. You see yourself coaching one day?
Definitely. I would love to be like a running back coach. Yeah.
You wouldn't even like, would you be cool like just being a running back coach, or would you like try to work your way up and take more responsibility, OC, head coach, like really try to climb the ladder?
I definitely could see that, you know, just kind of just learning and getting to the process of, you know, learning the plays and, you know, learning different defenses and stuff like that. So I definitely could see myself doing that for sure.
Yeah, I don't know, man. Like, do you think you could deal with all the personalities? Like, imagine the running back room we have now, and you're coaching them. How would you attack that? Like, how would you attack each guy?
I definitely would coach I would treat everybody the same. Mm-hmm. You know, coach them very hard. You know, teach them real well, and definitely just, you know, learning from Coach Smith and stuff like that.
You're a crash out kind of guy. You're gonna.
Nah, I don't really see myself like screaming as much like that unless I got to keep coaching you up on Just, you know, learning stuff from Coach Smith and stuff like that. Like, I could say, like, with having him in the room, like, he's been the best at just teaching us, like, you know, how to break different runs down and how to read different runs out to just make it easier. And so I definitely just learned from him. And
I don't know, maybe from a guy who's never really touched the rock like that, it seems like you kind of just go and do it. Like, it's, I feel like it'd be tough to get better or think a different way or run a different way than you're just used to running. Like, what are some things that he's taught you that you felt like, okay, in this situation, like, now I can fluently think to make this different move instead of making however I was doing before?
Well, first I can say, like, you know, just being at SMU, like, I was just used to, like, just getting the ball and just, like, you know, just going with the flow, just reading different holes and stuff like that. But, like, once I got here and when Coach Smith got here and he broke it down, like, the runs and stuff like that to me, man, you know, I'm a fast finesse guy. So, like I said, I'm used to just getting the ball and going. I think, like, when Smitty came in, he kind of, like, slowed my tempo down. And that's what helped me so much, bro. Like, just slowing my tempo down and just reading out the different blocks and, you know, being able to just have a two-way go, like going through the A gap, B gap, or making a cutback going backside. So he definitely made it easier for me to do that, man.
Yeah, for sure. I've only known you now, so, like, I would have just thought you were always kind of a patient back. Like, I see you back there working, analyzing, and then boom, creasing.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's awesome that that's something that you've added to your game that's prepared you like that. Does stuff like that help you in the return game too? Like, how do you view the return game and having that much space?
It definitely, like, just helps me a lot because you see a lot of guys, you know, catching the ball off kickoff return and they're just, like, shooting.
Right, yeah.
But rather with me, I like to really, like, just slow the game down for myself and just read it out. Once I read everything out, I can just use my speed and just hit it.
Right.
So that's what makes it easier for me.
Yeah, and man, I feel like we got a great special teams coach in Schoon. He's drawing great stuff up. A lot of times we were a block, half a block, a holding penalty away from really taking one back to the crib. So
yeah,
I'm definitely excited to see you get to work this year.
Man, I'm excited too, man. I definitely had a lot of ones last year that I could have just creased and ran, but I feel though for sure like this year is gonna be the one. We're gonna have a lot of returns.
I feel like it's terrifying to just sit back there and just like
and just watch it.
Cause how many? It's got to be like what, 4 or 5 seconds? The ball's in the air.
Yeah,
and you just. Are you looking? You looking straight at the ball the entire time, or like you peeping the scene, you peripheral what's developing? Like
more of it, I'm like kind of like I'm peeping the scene a little bit because like once I see the ball in the air and stuff like that, I know I'm gonna catch it.
Right,
I'm peeping the scene out just a little bit, and then once I get the ball, I'm just able to just like have a little tempo to it and just like read it out, and then that way I can just know just shoot it and just go for it.
Yeah, I know Schoon says a lot to step back a little bit, right, and then run into it. You feel like that helps you get things rolling instead of just catching it stationary and just trying to
That definitely helps
accelerate.
That definitely helps out a lot, just taking that step back, because if you just like, if you take that step back, like I said, it helps you read everything. So once you take that step back and do what you need to do with the ball, you can be able to score.
It's such a small detail that I feel like, boom, like that half second you get where this guy's, he would be right here, but I took that couple steps back and I ran into it. Now, you know, he's gone. He's behind me. I'm by him.
Yeah, all that stuff helps out, man, just the small details.
Yeah, all right. So with the room, it's looking a lot different. The makeup of it is a lot different than it was last year. What are your thoughts on Logan, the kid from LSU, and then maybe Henry Parrish coming through? Like, what are your thoughts on how the room could look in the fall?
I know during the fall it's gonna look real great. You know, Logan, he's getting back into it right now. He's you know working on his little injury or whatever. But once he come back during the season, you know everything is gonna be fine. And then like Henry, when he comes in, you know, like he was here before me, so pretty much, you know, he pretty much familiar with the offense and stuff like that. And, you know, I seen him make a few runs while he was here and while he was at Miami. So he's going to be – all of them is going to be pretty great.
Yeah, like, I feel like y'all got a great room going. And then even into the future, I feel like we got some young guys that can go to – Cat, how you feel about Cat?
Cat right now, you know, he's just learning, man. Mm-hmm. He's working hard each and every day. And I feel like, you know, he's just kind of like getting used to the offense and stuff like that. And he's also like figuring everything out of slowing his tempo down, reading each and every run out. So he's definitely getting better.
Yeah, what about four, man? Y'all been stealing Git a couple reps from us, having Git back there.
Oh yeah, we switched Git out, you know, kind of put him at running back a little bit, because I heard like he ran for like 250 yards.
Yeah, this is Santarin Perkins. They said they told me he ran for 3,000 yards in a season. I think his junior year, maybe? Yeah. Junior senior year. But yeah, I didn't even know he was doing like that. And me and a couple of my buddies cut on his highlights from high school the other day.
Yeah.
Just because I was like, I had just heard, and I was like, bro, this can't be your.
I didn't even know he played it, like, played running back.
The kid touched the ball, and it was in the end zone every single play. Like, it was crazy.
It's definitely, you know, a great use to have him back there. So, like,
yeah, that'd be nice as utility. Yeah. He were ATH. He were ATH.
This is Cali. With C Spire's blazing fast nationwide 5G network, she's got her fans in the palm of her hands. Live streaming her Mississippi Blues from her phone wherever she is. Out there, wherever they are. Right now, get the latest 5G phone on us. Only at C Spire, customer inspired.
Protecting homes and businesses from the whims of nature, you need more than just quality materials. You require Riverland Roofing. Licensed, insured, and certified, Riverland Roofing offers not only the assurance of excellence, but a tailored approach to your unique structural needs and budget. To learn more about what Riverland Roofing can do for you and the community, call them at 662-644-4297 or visit riverlandroofing.com.
You're in your process of returning, and how's that been, and what's the process been like?
Oh, the process has been great, man. You know, I've just been continually just going to treatment, trying to get better each and every week. I know I'm going to be back, you know, in the fall, and I just can't wait to be back out there with y'all, boy, so we can go get us a championship.
Man, I miss lining up against you, man, too. Yeah. Man. Get my little
bit. I definitely miss talking trash to y'all, scoring on y'all a little bit. So
they need you.
Yeah.
They need you. We've been having a pretty fire past couple of days.
Yeah,
I see. You know what I mean? You know? They need that spark back.
Yeah.
But you on the way.
Yeah.
All right. So we got some new opponents this year. Definitely some teams that I've never played. Florida, Oklahoma. Mm-hmm. What are some games that you're looking forward to this year?
Definitely, like, I would say, like, LSU, Florida, Georgia, Kentucky.
Oh, yeah, that'd be
good. I'm looking forward to those games because I didn't get to play Kentucky the first.
Oh, no?
Yeah, remember, I was hurt.
So yeah. That was
my wrist.
The wrist.
I was out that game. So it's definitely going to be fun to go there and, you know, win that.
Yeah, that'd be a good one. That'd be a good one because they feel like they owe us.
Mm-hmm.
They definitely feel like they owe us. That was a crazy, crazy.
That was the craziest game ever.
Because like, they really, they, I mean, after that screen pass that went for like 60, I mean, they had all the momentum in the world.
For real, though.
So that was definitely a tight one. I'm excited for that. I'm really excited to play Oklahoma.
Yeah.
I think we got them at home, right?
Yeah, we played them at home.
Man, I kind of do wish we were going there, though.
Yeah. I never been to Oklahoma.
Nah,
so.
The whole state.
Yeah, I've never been. So. Nah, I've been there playing Tulsa.
True.
Playing Tulsa, but I've never been to Oklahoma.
Yeah, that's I think that's a little bit different vibe. A little bit different environment.
Yeah.
Than Tulsa. No shade to Tulsa. But I think that would have been really cool. I think they have one of the coolest fight songs in college football.
That atmosphere is just crazy. They're just watching it on TV, seeing guys like Baker Mayfield and all those guys.
I mean, what, three Heismans in a row?
Yes. Crazy.
Yeah, that's insane. Back to the foot real quick. I don't ever think I found out like what the real injury was or what was the cause of everything going.
So I had what's called turf toe. Mm. You know, it's kind of like, you know, I do a lot of running and stuff like that and a lot of cutting. Mm. So like once you do a lot of cutting and stuff, it starts to affect your big toe. And what's crazy is, man, like when I heard it and I kind of like went to the doctors and stuff, they told me like I played through the whole year with it. And I'm like, I've never felt
any, you never felt anything.
Bro, I've never felt any pain at all.
When did it start to spring up?
Like probably like the last game, like the bowl game. Mm. And like I kind of felt it. And I'm like, man, that's like, that's crazy. But you know, they just like, I went through surgery and stuff. Luckily, I ain't had to get no screws or anything. Mm. They just pulled the sesamoid bone out and, you know, I'm just recovering.
The sesamoid, where is the sesamoid?
It's like right under the toe.
So from
like,
your hand, well, imagine.
It's like a,
your hand is the foot, my thumb is the big toe.
It's like right under.
Right here?
Yeah, like right under.
Yeah, man. Yeah. So they just pulled it out?
Yeah, just pulled it
out. And it just heals on its own in a cast?
Yep. Ah. Just heals on its own.
What have you been doing? Have you been you've been walking any without the boot or toe ups and whatever?
They've been kind of having me like do like leg lifts. Mm. I ain't really been walking on.
Just strengthening the calf.
Yeah, just strengthening my calves, yeah. And legs up. So yeah.
We were just off from lifting earlier, or was yesterday? Or we had the day off, just meetings because the pro day rolled through.
Yeah.
Did you stay to watch any of it?
Yeah, I stayed to watch it. I watched all those guys. Yeah. Man, you know, definitely, you know, just from seeing those guys playing from the past season, mm-hmm. and just seeing what they're doing now, man, I just, you know, pray for them and hope, you know, everything goes best for them.
Yeah, they were out there doing their thing, man. Spencer's making throws.
Yeah.
Them guys was out there making catches, man. D-Wade looked silky smooth. Everybody ran pretty fast.
Yeah.
Does it have you kind of excited to – get in the next year and you know, conquer the season and you know what I mean? Make that next step?
Oh, yeah, definitely, man. I can't wait till I get to that part because I'm going to go crazy. Yeah. And it's going to be crazy to see just like, you know, our whole team is just like full of seniors, full of older guys. Yeah. So it's going to be a bunch of us.
Yeah, we're going to be deep. Yeah, pro day going to be deep. So I know you're a track guy. Mm-hmm. What do you think you're running the 40?
I give myself 4.34.
4.34?
Yeah.
Solid.
Yeah.
Very solid.
Yeah.
I get myself. You say 4.34. I say 4.32, something like
4.32?
That.
4.32?
Like, if you coming with the 4.34, yeah. Then I got to, you know what I mean?
Okay,
like,
then.
4.32. I can't just let you have all the fun. I got to really turn 4.32? The jets on.
Yeah.
I mean, who knows?
You know what I'm saying?
Anything can happen.
Anything.
It's pro day. It's pro Anything day. Can happen, man.
Yeah.
What about bench? You big bench guy?
No, I'm not a big bench guy. But, nah,
but you will be.
I will be will during be, that yeah. time, though. I can see myself 225 hitting at least about a good 15,
I see,
18.
Yeah. I see
you. Know,
I see
but,
you grabbing 15, 18. I think Isaac just hit 23 or 24, which is a great number. I'm just trying to be in the 20s, man.
Yeah. If I can get that, I'll be good.
Did you see I'm not sure what he hit, but that kid from South Carolina,
it's a freak.
Like, he's huge. I'm not sure how many he hit, but I heard he just blew everything out the water. Like, just tested crazy, hit something crazy on bench. It's really country. He got the thickest country accent I've ever heard in my life.
Oh, the receiver.
The receiver.
Yeah. That's crazy.
Yeah, so.
He built almost like DK, though.
He built like DK, I think a little shorter, I think.
Yeah.
I honestly see him as a running back. Like,
you see him as a running back?
If I just saw a picture of him, I'd have been like, oh, yeah, he's on the rock.
Yeah.
But, nah, apparently he got elite speed, and he was doing his thing, so. Yeah, I'm definitely on the lookout for him too.
Nah, for real.
What do you think about the translation from like true speed into the game, right? Like the kid from Texas, what's his name? Xavier Quickly?
Worthy.
Worthy. Xavier Worthy just ran a record number. How do you really think that translates to the game? Like, or do you feel like once you hit a certain speed, like it's all about what you can do with the rock?
For me, like, I would say, like, to a lot of guys just coming up to college and in high school right now, like, bro, I advise you, like, run track, bro. Mm-hmm. Like, it helps you with your form. Because a lot of guys, you know, they just, like, they kind of run. And it's just regular. And you kind of see guys that kind of fighting it when they're running like that. Instead of just, like, when you see Worthy run, he ran very smooth.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, all that track stuff, it just relates to that, man. And that helps you to be able to just get out and run very fast and to pick your knees up too.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. A lot of guys would be so much faster if they had that technique.
That's all, bro.
As far as linemen go, it would help crazy with your hips, like even just getting out there and running track, like having loose hips. Because, I mean, there's so many guys that are just got crazy strength and or maybe crazy quickness, but, you know, they can't put it together because they don't got the fluidity.
And it's definitely possible for y'all to do, because you see a lot of guys in the NFL right now. They're big, just like y'all, with a lot of speed.
Got a lot of speed, got them hips, got that twist, got that bend.
Yeah.
You know? So what about, okay, now we're into me, we're into you. I'm a D-lineman, you're a running back. How do you feel about pass pro? What kind of pass pro guy are you?
You know.
What's going through your mind? You see 260 running at you.
Oh, dang. I see 260 running
you
at
see,
me.
You see 260 running at you, man. What's going on? We were running a little blitz in this pattern. You know, puts the big head right on you.
At that point, like I was just telling the guys earlier today, like when you see things like that, like guy like 260 coming at you, I just kind of like strap my helmet up. It's just like, hey, man, I just got to take it.
You don't shy away from it, though.
I don't. You just got to take it for the team, man. And it's just like, it's just a little hit. It might hurt for a few seconds, but you'll be all right the next play.
You know what I don't like, man? Y'all be taking y'all shot on a chip.
Yeah.
Oh, you knew where I was going.
Yeah. If he's like that. If he's too, I could say like if he's 260, you know, a little lean, I probably can just take him straight up.
Yeah.
But if he's just like just super, just duper big, nah, I'm finna come right here and chop them legs.
Well, not even a – well, so that too is crazy. I got chopped last year. That was not fun. Came so free. Running backs right here. Boom, dives last second. Yeah. Took me out. But I'm in a chip like off the edge.
Yeah,
like
the shoulder.
You about to go to the flats. Yeah.
You know, they definitely teach us like, if y'all beating the tackle around the edge or something like that, kind of hit y'all in the ribs a little bit. But, I definitely love chipping. I love that.
I bet you do.
Yeah.
I bet you. I love doing that.
Because when you do it, you know, they kind of come around the edge. They looking for a little bit. They looking. Mm-hmm. But it's like, man, I got to be smooth. I can't come too hard because that running back might come and hit me in the ribs. Mm-hmm. So that definitely, like, just stops them from doing
it. After the first one, it's like you don't rush the same.
Yeah.
Right, because like I'm not even really thinking about it, and Keg got me last week. Had a good little stab cup on Jaden.
Yeah,
I'm like, oh, boom! I'm right there. I just got the edge. Like I'm finna accelerate. Ah, straight to the rest.
Straight to the ribs.
You know that. Ooh. Yeah, man. Just took my breath away, man. That was a tough one. That was a tough one. What about hurdling? Like you chip guys, you know what I mean? You might dive at somebody's ankles. If somebody's diving at yours, would you jump them?
Yeah. Huh? Like I would. Only like, it's tough, bro, because I don't really do a lot of hurdling. Like just for me, because I don't like the landing part. Like seeing a lot of guys like land and come down and fall hard, I don't really do too much hurdling. But if I feel like I can really just take it and like really do it, like, I heard of somebody, but
I feel like if it's like nobody behind you.
Yeah.
Like, if it's people behind you.
Or on the side of you.
Or on the side, no chance.
No chance at all.
But if it's like a phone booth, I notice guys diving. Yeah. I might take that risk.
Yeah.
I might take that risk. I got into an argument when I first got here in the locker room with like Zay, OT, KD.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm unhurdleable.
You feel like that?
At 6'6", like, I feel like you got to jump so high. Yeah, like, I'm not diving in nobody's legs.
Yeah, that's over, man.
You know what I mean? I feel like I can't be hurdled.
Yeah.
I say that now, and then the flying piggies is out there on offense and team run. And
I don't really feel like hurdled. You can get hurdled, though. Like, nah. Too tall, bro.
Terrifying, though. Like, because me, if I feel like in the moment, if I know, if you look like you're about to set up a jump, I'm going to just stand straight up.
Yeah, and it's over boom. Once that happens.
Yeah,
somebody's getting slammed at that point.
Oh man, what about you saw that play? I think it was Florida State LSU when Jaden Daniels tried to hurdle that guy.
That was bad.
And ended up.
See, something like that, like how we was just talking about it, like he had people on the side of him, in the front of him, behind him. Like that's the worst times to do it.
Fearless though.
He definitely got hit hard.
Fearless for that.
Yeah.
You've been seeing that that picture of his elbow?
Yes. His throwing motion? It looks weird, bro.
It's odd.
I don't know. Like, I've never seen anything like
that. Like, I'm trying to get into that position.
Yeah.
Where my jump would, like, stick out. Like, I just don't. Ooh. I don't see how that's possible.
I don't even think I would want to see anything like that.
Like, it looks like he's hurt.
Yeah.
Like, it looks like throwing the ball hurts for him. Never seen anything like it, bro.
I've never seen anything like that. That's crazy, though.
What about some weird, like, you ever seen a guy just, like, with a weird body part? Weird body part guy.
A weird body part guy.
Someone is just a, this guy's got an odd this, you know?
I can talk about my dog, Micah. His knees.
Man, yeah, yeah.
His knees come in. But he blocks very hard. He can run too. So
listen, like, he blocks his ass off.
Yeah, he does.
The guy's knees are concave, though.
Literally, though.
They are. They are. It's an odd angle. And he stands with them so close.
Yes, bro. I just be looking at him like, does that hurt? Like,
just assess him for a second. Like, his feet are hip width apart.
Yeah.
Knees still touching.
That's crazy.
It's crazy.
Sorry, Micah.
Speaking of Daniels, too, Zay has a huge, big Zay, Xavier Harris, has a giant lump. Like,
I've seen that.
On both of his knees.
I've seen that.
Like, his kneecaps are just huge.
That's like, I ain't gonna lie, that's like my first time ever seeing like somebody.
Never seen anything like that.
That's crazy.
It's like a real like elbow on his kneecap. It's the weirdest thing.
He said elbow.
Yeah. I just said
and it's crazy to see him like how big he is, bro. Mm-hmm. Like, he be running.
Gigantic. The guy came in at, like, 380.
Yeah.
390. He weighs, like, 290 pounds now.
That's crazy.
He lost almost 100 pounds. And on top of that, he was already quick and fast when he got here. Now, I think the guy, like, training for the 40 could run, like, a 4.5.
He's definitely a beast, bro. Man. And definitely when I'm running the ball and I see him, I'm like, oh, yeah, I gotta get up out of here.
he's a genetic freak.
Yeah.
No cap. It's the knees. Maybe if I like.
I couldn't even imagine it.
Just push my joints out. Like, take a hammer to them. Make, you know, like a knot from a cartoon.
Take a little knot out. And put kid, it right
like,
in.
Boom, you get hit in the head with a hammer, like some Looney Tunes. And then it just grow out. Maybe that'll happen. Maybe I'll get a little step quicker.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Probably.
But man, nah. Super excited to get into it this year, man. I appreciate you coming on, bro. It's always good.
Yeah, man, for sure.